Hello, and welcome back to my yearly upload schedule. Today, well, you can already read the title, but today's video is how to install G64 again, since it changed this time. And the mod's been getting updated. It hasn't been updated recently, but it's more updated than it used to be. And people have been asking, can you make a follow-up video? It's different, and so here I am. So first things first, you're gonna need a few things. The first thing I can't help you with, which is a N64 Mario 64 ROM, and it has to be .z64. I can't tell you where to get that. I can't help you in getting it in any way because of legal reasons. I do not endorse illegally obtaining video games. Now Nintendo, please do not assassinate me. The next thing you're gonna need to have is the Chromium beta of Gary's mod. And if you don't know how to get that, I'll show you right now. Now first you go to properties, then you go to betas. Then where it says none, you select x86 and -64, and that should be the right one. And then it'll start downloading, and then you just wait for it to finish. Now once the download's finished, you're gonna wanna go back to the Gary's Mod page, and when you press play, you're gonna get these launch options. Do the 64-bit option. That option is required. I know in my previous video I said I didn't know if it was required, but I liked using it because it worked with my add-ons, which was true. I neglected to see that it literally says you need it on the page. So that one's on me, guys. But so, you must be running on the Chromium 64-bit in order for G64 to run. So now that we have everything we need, we will now follow the instructions on the GitHub. That will be linked in the description along with the workshop add-on. And so, we will now follow those instructions, which do say to download the workshop add-on. So you do that first, then you will download and run the G64 installer. Now, unfortunately, following these steps, I ran into an issue. So first things first, I ran into Windows Defender, and that doesn't mean anything. It's just Windows trying to protect you from being an idiot. But I decided to not tempt fate and just do it the same way I did last time. And secondly, when I ran into the game, I got this error in the console. And unfortunately, I may be a coding nerd, but I found the answer right now. So I ended up fixing this because it was running an older version of G64. And so what I had to do is go find the add-on, which can be in your Gary's Mod folder location with the rest of your add-ons, or in your Steam Workshop add-ons. It's supposed to be a temp folder, I think at least. And that's where a bunch of add-ons are stored. And using the ID numbers, I found it. So after finding it, I then just saw there was two add-ons in there. It was loading the old one. I just deleted the old one, and that fixed the problem. But you don't really have to do this, as long as you just ignore that window. So if you want to follow along with what I did, I went to the releases page, downloaded the zip of that. So like we did in the last video, we're gonna extract our libs64 zip file into our Gary's Mod. And if you don't know how to find that, you can just go to browse local files on Steam for Gary's Mod. If you wanna verify it's there, check for these files. If those files are not in those locations, then you might have misplaced it. Otherwise, you're golden. So now once you finally get in game, you wanna go into your spawn menu, go over to Utilities, go to G64 Settings, and at the top, there should be a little text window. In that text window, you can either type in the location of your ROM, or you can click the Browse function. I've heard the Browse function does not work, so just in case, you might want to copy the location of your Mario 64 ROM file into that little text box. If the Browse function works for you, you're golden. And then once you do that, you go into G64 on the tabs on the top, spawn in Mario, and now you get to play as Mario. G64 is officially working.